So we've been talking a lot about getting back to the roots of biotechnology since we've been here in Des Moines this week. However, those roots don't just grow to the U.S. They extend from North America, South America, Europe, and all the way to Australia. That global growth, however, would not be possible without industry advocates who realize the benefits of the life sciences industry and are ensure that it exists and thrive in their home country. I'm standing here today with Mario Panizzi, an industry advocate when it comes to industrial biotechnology, specifically in Queensland. Each year, Bio recognizes a leader in industrial biotechnology through the Leadership and Legacy Award, and Mario is a 2019 winner of that award here at the Bio World Congress. First off, congratulations, yeah, Mario, and thank you for joining us here at the Buzz Center.
My pleasure, and thank you for inviting me.
Absolutely. So the life science industry globally is seemingly exploding in countries, whether it be solutions to fight climate change, to secure our food supply, or even for health needs. Can you give us a little bit of an idea of what is driving the growth of the life sciences industry in Queensland?
Yeah, well, it's pretty much all the things that you've just talked about. We recognize that our future relies on renewable and sustainable practices. And this industry, more than any other, really deploys technology that enables that to happen. So it is really the need for us to ensure that we will survive as a race. And as I've heard a friend say at this meeting, there's no planet B. Mm-hmm. So that's what's driving it for Australia, and that's what's driving it for everybody, in fact. We have to get this right.
Is there a specific innovation or a specific technology or purpose that is really driving it, whether it be biofuels or bio-based products? What is it in Queensland that is really allowing the industry to thrive?
Yeah, so it's a whole multitude of things, and of course you need to start somewhere where the general population will come on board and understand what the opportunity is. And biofuels, we've got a biofuels mandate, that has helped bring effectively our sugarcane industry, not exclusively our sugarcane, but that's where most of the action is, to support that industry to the table. But of course, as you know, and as you've heard here in Des Moines this week, if you go out and look just outside this convention, 5 miles outside this convention center, you're driving through fields and fields of corn. Now, we talk about a bioeconomy in Queensland. We in fact call it a biofutures strategy. You know, we're looking forward, right? So, but if we talk about a bioeconomy as this meeting does and many other meetings do, just take a walk outside here in Des Moines or anywhere in Queensland now. If you took the biotech component out of what is happening in those communities, there'd actually be no economy. The bioeconomy is so entrenched in everything that we do now, and to quote Jim Greenwood, to feed, fuel and heal us. If those things weren't happening using biotechnology, there'd be no economy.
And that bioeconomy, again, doesn't just exist here in the U.S., it exists globally, as Mario mentioned. And you mentioned, you call it the future.
Biofutures. We call it biofutures.
Biofutures. Can you give me an idea of what the next decade is going to look like for Queensland when it comes to industrial biotechnology?
So we'll double down. I don't work for the government. I work as an advocate, as you've correctly identified. Working with the government, trying to listen to what the community is needing, talking to our academics and talking to industry and talking to the industry and the people in this very room, I think we'll be doubling down on those things that we're doing to have more mandates to take waste out of to take waste streams and turn them into higher value products. You know, if we can remove plastic from everyday rubbish tips or garbage tips, as you would call them here, and turn that plastic into something more valuable, not only do we do something good for the environment, but we do something good for the economy.
Absolutely, and you talk about coming to the World Congress and really being able to network with people to establish those connections. And when you received the award at the lunch plenary we had earlier today, there was a huge delegation from Queensland.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, isn't it?
It's really cool to see the international attendance here at the Bio World Congress, especially from Queensland. And Queensland has been a part of the Bio World Congress for a good amount of years now.
Ten years. We've had an actual delegation for 10 years. We had people coming before that. But, you know, this conference has been going, 16, 17 years?
17 years.
So pretty much we've probably had people here from the beginning. But as an actual delegation, we've been coming for 10 years, and I've been very pleased to have been part of making that happen. And it's important. It's important for our state. It's important for the world. it's important for this community that we're in today.
Absolutely, we're trying to grow the global bioeconomy, and part of that is ensuring that we have the international presence, such as what's happening in Queensland here at the Bio World Congress, so we continue to strengthen the bioeconomy globally, or should I say biofutures.
I think it's about our biofuture.
Yes, absolutely. Well, Mario, I want to thank you for stopping by the bus.
Oh, thank you.
Congratulations again.
Thank you. Thank you very much.